Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about nasal dermal sinus imaging. Dermology, effective embryogenesis of anterior nerve root cord. Results in any mixture of dermoids, epidermoids, and our sinus tract in frontal nasal region. Present is the most common sign and symptom. Nasal glabellomas, 30%. Pitch on skin of nasal bridge at osteocartilaginous nasal junction, plus minus protruding hair. Other signs, symptom, intermittent discharge of sebaceous material from pit, less than 50% have broadening of nasal root and breath. Nasal sinus tract rarely leads to recurrent meningitis. Clinical profile. Child, mid-age, around 32 months, with nasal pit, plus minus nasal glabellar mass, rarely present in adult population. Meningitis may be first problem leading to diagnosis. Demographic age, newborn to 5 years old, sex male, patient with dermal sinus are more likely to have intracranial extension. Epidemiology. Congenital midline nasal lesions are rare. Nasal dermoid is most common. Imaging. Midline location anywhere from nasal tip to anterior scar base at foramen sequel. Humeral tissue, fluid signal tract in septum from nasal dorsum to scar base. T2, focal lobe signal, epidermoid or non-fatty dermoid or high signal dermoid, must between tip of nose and apex of crystal calline. CT, bifid crystal calline with large foramen sequel. Fluid attenuation tract sinus, cyst, epidermoid or fat containment dermoid, from nasal dorsum to scar base within nasal septum. Non-contrasting NCT in her 8 years old with known midline anomaly, so fat line, nasal dermal sinus, deep to nasal bone, the sinus lead to a large fat and fluid attenuation. Dermoid, there is a wide foramen sequel with fatty fossae extending along the front. Agenesis of the corpus callosum is also noted. T1 of I in the same patient. So the red line nasal dermal sinus, large mixed signal intensity dermoid, and far sign fossae of fat. Agenesis of the corpus callosum is again noted. The dermoid was ultimately resected. Note that the size and extent of finding in this case is greater than type polycine. Non-contrasting CT demonstrate a characteristic low attenuation dermoid centered in the cartilaginous portion of the nasal septum. The mass is slightly higher in the attenuation than adjacent fat. T1C plus FS more in a 4 months old infant with clavulanus demonstrate non-enhancing fluid signal intensity dermosis with the remodeling of the underlying nasal bone. Although dermosis may contain fat, the majority of them do not. T2MI in a 1-year-old with a mass at the tip of his nose shows an avoid hyperfat intense mass and a tubular lesion traversing the nasal septum to the foramen cecum without intracranial extension at the level of foramen cecum. The lesion demonstrates diffusion restriction, typical of a dermoid. Treatment: 80% require extracranial incision only. Local procedure to remove it. Any associated dermoid or repeated dermoid is simultaneously removed from nasal bed. 20% undergo combined extracranial and intracranial resection. B. Orbital frontal nasal craniotomy approach. And midline approach via keyhole frontal craniotomy has been recently described and less blood loss and shorter hospital stay. Thank you.